So I've taken on a project for our local tool library. They're trying to build over 500 desks for the kids who basically are going to school from home and can't afford a desk. So I went to the hardware store today, bought a whole bunch of plywood. I should turn this down. Today I went out and bought a bunch of plywood and one by three pine boards, and we're gonna try and make some desks. Like with most of the things I do, I like to draw them out first so I get a good idea of how I need to build them. So we're going to draw them out today. So this is the PDF for the desk design. Put this over here. So, I volunteered to make the desks, and these are kind of what they want. So we went out and bought the sanded plywood. For some reason, the veneered maple was cheaper than the poplar, so I bought maple. And it has a very thin veneer on it, but it looks pretty nice, so we'll try and make these look as nice as possible. We bought the standard pine and the rest of the materials, so we're good to go. These desks are very simple. All the parts are laid out here, so it actually shouldn't take too long to draw out. But there are a few things we can do to make it a little bit nicer, and we're going to try and do that. They kind of outline what you can do in these instructions. So we're going to be working with 4x8 sheets, so we'll have to use the diagram to cut them out. Maybe I'll draw out the diagram as well. But you can see that's kind of what the desk is gonna look like. And the rest are just kind of instructions, but the parts that I'm interested in working on a little better, you can add a special touch by routing a pencil tray front of the cubby. So we're going to do that. Try and make that look as nice as possible. And since it's plywood, we might end up using a lot of wood filler. But we'll make it look nice. Make it all smooth. There was another thing on here. There was a little spot. Maybe I'm scrolled over it. This. Right here, there's an option to like route a channel into the top of the desk so people can put a tablet or a clipboard, maybe a phone. So we're going to try and make that happen. I have some router bits. I'm going to have to make some kind of a jig. I'd like to draw it, but I think we're going to have to, I don't know if I have enough information at the moment. We'll just have to figure it out as we go. And then we're going to make sure there's no sharp edges. And we're going to, I bought some natural polyurethane stain. Stain and finish. So I bought a few different products that we're going to try out that I don't have a ton of experience working with, but we will see. Anyway, we'll put this to the side. I had some like wrist pain from working at the computer so much, so I'm just trying to work slow. All right, I'll get this PDF up. So I think we'll start by laying out the parts. Our first piece, the desktop, is 24¾ by 17¾. I hope you can hear my cat in the background. She's going nuts. All right. So I always like to start off by getting my view in an above. One in an above view. If anyone has questions about SketchUp, I'm happy to answer. This is the online version. I like to do these, I like to use the online version with all the simple products. Projects. I like to use the online version for the simple projects, mostly because this transfers to my laptop just really easy. So that's kind of what I do. That when I'm streaming in the garage, I can just pull up a drawing or working or anything. So that's the length of the desktop. It's possible that mine are going to be a little bit shorter or not as big because I want to make sure each edge is as neat and flush as possible. So I might just take a little bit off on each edge. So that's our desktop. We're just gonna make that a component. Click three times, make component. All right, now we can actually just way down, and I want this to be different because we're going to make them different later on. So I'm going to make this unique. That way this anything I do to this one doesn't affect this one. And so I realized that this one actually needs to be 23, not it's a little bit shorter. Just going to make a reference line. Edit this component. Pull it right there. Boom. Making the desk back. I'm just gonna move this. It has to actually go in between. Put it right there, actually. There. see how quickly this is coming together. The legs will be a little bit tricky, but that's about it. So it looks like the top, okay. Kind of misunderstood how this was supposed to work, but yeah, it's okay. That's why I draw. That's literally the top. This is super easy. It's going to be much more difficult to go out and make it. All right, I don't need the warehouse. I need the colors. They asked that it be a natural colored wood. Mine's maple, so it's gonna be a little more. Probably the right color anyway. Oh, hey. Tea lit tea. Glad you're around. Yeah, I can't, I don't think I could do anything without SketchUp. Just helps me understand things better. I like draw out everything in my house before I like move anything. It's like a little obsessive, I think, but. How are you doing today? So we're just gonna make these legs. I'm just gonna draw a center point. I'm gonna go for a run in Vegas. Awesome. That sounds amazing. Yeah. Man, I used to run just about every day. Kind of miss it. much stopped when I started working at my current job. So I always work 12-hour days, and it's just really hard to... It's hard to, after a 12-hour day, I don't really want to go for a run. I don't know. I used to be a wrestler, so I used to do quite a bit of exercise. Yeah. They have their benefits because I get technically get more days off when I work 12 hours days, but I also have to do more overtime than I want, so that's another problem. So I'm just working through these legs. I'll show you here what I'm working on. So I'm doing this project. There's like a bunch of children that are going to school at home and can't afford desks to work at. So the Minnesota Tool Library is asking people to help build desks. That's what I'm working on. I just went to Menards today and bought all the supplies. That's what we're gonna do. Are you streaming today, T-Lit? They will actually provide the materials. If I go there, I can pick up the materials, but I just went and bought them myself, so I can just kind of donate them. They're not expensive materials. The most expensive thing is the plywood, and it's like $50 a sheet, 50 something a sheet. So I bought 2 sheets of plywood, and it makes 8 desks, so really not that expensive. Dignified Hospitality Manifesto. What is that? That sounds great. Writing up a manifesto of how the hospitality. Hi, Dusty, can restructure. Bring more dignity to the food workers and customer industry. Yeah. Hi, Dusty. I should have been able to figure that out. Well, that sounds awesome. So you would be like trying to figure out how, like, what kind of industry you're talking about, like caterers or like food service in general? Okay, so you're trying to get on the this like a new wave. I get that. It definitely would be nice to see when the new restaurants reopen, some better practices. Like, I think where I live kind of by Minneapolis, St. Paul, requires new legislation. I don't know. There's so many restaurants out there. You can just tell, like, their workers are paid so poorly, and they use just like the worst quality food, and then they just thrive. And people keep going to that stuff. Be nice to see something better. Because we buy cheap stuff, or I don't know. Why don't, I mean, we have street food, but not like street food. I suppose the way that other countries see street food, yeah, we don't have street food. We have food trucks and fair food. Yeah, and it's all the legislation is quote unquote for food safety when doesn't really do that much, does it? Sorry, I'm not really doing anything. I'm trying to figure out how big these legs need to be. It says to use yeah, 32 inch boards and then cut them at the parallel. So I'm just gonna make a board and cut it. I don't know though, because there are some places, like I live in St. Paul, Minneapolis, there are some restaurants that are really doing a good job, but it's by no means street food. And like half of them end up closing after a few years because their good model is probably their good model. It's hard to run. I don't know. I'd be happy to see something new come out all something new and good come out of all of this stuff. Oh yeah. For sure. My grandma used to I just did a stream. My last stream was I did a Skype session with my grandma. We made lefse. And she told me how many years she slaved to make lefse for people. And sold it for like $1 a piece. Like next to nothing. And you legally probably could not do that. I mean, like, if you were gonna make that operation bigger, you'd need all kinds of licenses and insurance. Yeah, good luck. I don't know why these are separated, because the other parts are a component. Unless this isn't a, it should be a component. I don't get it. Why? Yeah, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you later. Seems like really tall. I guess I still gotta move it. Sure, I can turn this properly. this project a name. Alright, so I have to keep looking back at this plan. We just want to make sure we're building it to their specifications. So if I did this right, this should be 11 and a half. It's only like 10 and something. Alright. But if I do their specifications, I have to have done something wrong. I'm gonna reread. Give you a little picture here. Put this over here so you can still see it. I think I cut them right. This board is, I think they need to be 32 with the blocking your view. Sorry. disorienting there, I'm sorry. PDF says this should be eleven and a half. But now these are cut at 32, so, and they have an exact 10-degree mark. That's probably going to be where it's at. Seems like an awfully long. It seems like a really high desk. Like, I doubt my desk even comes up to that high. I don't know, maybe it's fine. Oh, did I leave that up again? Jeez, I'm sorry. Hey. What's up, Bobo? What's going on today? Well, I offered to make two of them for the organization, and I'm not really sure how they want us to drop them off or if they need me to deliver it. We'll see what they need. They actually emailed me to start because they need people to make these things. So I offered to make two of them, but I bought enough to make eight. So we'll see how long they take. They do supply the wood, but the supplies that they required, like I'll show you here. Go to my supply list. The supplies they require are like dirt cheap for the most part. So I just went and bought it, and I'll donate it. Yeah. So I'm glad they emailed me, because I wouldn't have really cared to make desks otherwise, so. But be something I can do with my free time, I guess. All right, the last part is the back brace. And then I'm gonna fool around with trying to make a jig so I can carve the extras in. Cause they wanna try and put a groove like right along here so kids can prop up a tablet or a clipboard or a phone and just sit inside of the, it can just be propped up there. And then they want a groove in right in this inside of the cubby, it sounds like, so you can put pencils and stuff. So, try to make that happen. This part's easy, the down part. The part up here is difficult because I'll actually show you why. If we go down to where they ask us to do this. They have this groove in at an angle. So this is like a tablet and they just put this groove in the top of the desk. It's easy to make any kind of groove, but to put it in at an angle like that, I have to make a jig. So I'll have to figure out the jig. Probably be really easy if I just ran it across the table saw, but there's a reason I don't want to do that. Alright, we'll put the back of this on. And easy. I wonder if that's how they actually want it. Kind of looks like that. Well, that's fine. Although I may end up planing part of that to look a little neater. All right, so that's the basic desk that they have, they want people to build. So I'm gonna hide all these and we're gonna work on the front groove there. Say we want it to be a pencil groove for pencils, maybe pens, I guess. Checking back in the plans. Small pencil tray. Students with storage boxes that are 12 inches by 12 inches. I don't know what they mean by that. Routing a pencil tray near the front of the cubby. So I wanna draw this out. So they apparently got a 12 by 12 tray. Or something. So they're gonna put in a little drawer type thing here. Did ya? Well, that's okay. It's on a VOD form, so you can watch it. I'm gonna edit it down too and put it on YouTube. Did I go to my parents? No. We were just on Skype. I turned the video on and she just watched me make it. So that's how we've been Skyping a lot, trying to because I don't want to go see her right now. That'd be like not ideal. But yeah, every once in a while, I just turn on Skype and she watches me cook or do something else weird, trying to keep her entertained or whatever. I don't know. She's like, it seems like all she has to do at home is just sit and watch TV. So, trying to at least make it more interesting. Yeah, right. I don't know. I'm trying to get it so we don't have to do Christmas gifts this year. Yeah, I would like to not spend more money this year. Hey, oil change. How you doing, man? I got a book so far. Got a book for your girlfriend, wife. Book would be nice. I was thinking about only buying gifts in the form of local business gift cards. Like, it's like every year my parents ask what I want, and this year just makes no sense to do anything weird or to buy more stupid stuff from Amazon. I just want my parents to like go to the local brewery and buy me a gift card. That way, even if I never use it, the money will go to a local business. But I'll probably use it if it's a brewery. They don't have like a finished drawing of the actual thing. The one that they have is like, it doesn't match their what they said. Show ya. Like they have this little tiny thing there, and it doesn't exactly match up to what they're saying I should do. The dimensions basically say it should look like what I drew, but in this little tiny picture, looks like the legs go like right on the side. Put my phone in a slot that's not angled. I suppose you could. But I think if you put anything, like the slot is only supposed to be half an inch, which I don't even know if my phone would even fit into that. So there'd be no wobble room. And I think that's what they're thinking, that if they put a tablet in there's not going to be any wobble room. And it will just sit up straight. So if you put it in at an angle, then it would be angled. If that makes sense. Like they literally in the PDF they show it like a tablet right here. And like it wobbles a little bit in there, but if you had it straight up, it would be more straight. That makes any sense. Yeah, no problem, dude. Appreciate you coming by. All right, I'm not really sure that I'm building this the way they want it exactly, because this obviously looks different. But this makes more sense than having it just straight on the side, so I don't think they expect much out of this. So we're just gonna kind of go with it. I don't really know what they mean by the tray being out of the way. Where did that part go? A pencil tray near the front of the cubby. So I'm just gonna interpret that however I interpret it because I don't, whatever. I'll probably end up calling him before I actually build it to make sure I'm doing it okay. So this is going to be my center line. Maybe that's too far in. That's not the center line, that's the outside. An inch should be more than enough, I think. Maybe it should be a half inch. Make it an inch to center. Oh, I wasn't editing the component. Thank you. You guys gotta tell me when I'm doing this. I'm so sorry I was blocking you. So this is what I drew up. I drew a pencil holder. Is essentially what I did. And now if I had any skills, I would be able to hollow this out. Make it see-through first so I can see into it. We'll grab... How big's a pencil? At least a quarter inch. Here, let me get a tape measure. One moment. So a thin pencil is about a quarter of an inch, a little bit bigger maybe. So if I grab Sharpie is about half an inch, it's less than half. Thinking I should make it. Have Sharpies. Thinking it should be a half inch. So make it a half inch deep for now. Wow, that's deep. So I drew that inside of there. We want to make this round, put an arc. Wonder if I pull this. Probably work, wouldn't it? See if this makes it look good. Ugh. Man, that's gonna be too deep, isn't it? It should be a quarter of an inch. So that's like a full half inch deep. Ryan's gonna want to pull that out. That at least makes more sense. Alright, I really don't know how to make this. I would have to scale it up, I think. I think that's the proper angle, but it might be enough. Probably won't even let me. If I can follow that. Whoa, what was that? Is that it? No way. It's a weird shape I made. is this thing never... There we go. Alright. Gotta take a quick break. Be right back. Hey. One moment. Hey, I'm going to build in wood. Yes. Just saw your message. Plywood for the top, and it's just 1x3 pine for the legs. It's a really inexpensive, cheap project. Charity for the Minnesota Tool Library. They're building desks for the basically Minneapolis students that are at school right now. They're at home, they can't go to school, and they can't afford a desk, so we're building them desks. I'll be right back. I'm just gonna go to the bathroom quick, and then I'll come back. One moment. I'll mute it so you can't hear. Okay, we're back. All right. So we got this pretty... I'm going to try and mess around with those circles a little bit more and try and get it... Get that routing deal to look nice. But you can see the tray. It looks like I have a tray. Try and make those corners look nice, and then we'll see if we can add the little attachment to the other groove. We want to add the other groove. Maybe we should add. That's just gonna be a. Maybe I'll put a. Add another source. Just wanna put the logo up. People kinda know what I'm working on. I'm terrible at SketchUp, so this is what I'm doing here. Hopefully, if I build if I do this correct, then I will be able to just drag it into the other side. It's gotta be the worst way to do it, but be able to just take the follow me tool and be able to drag it around, but I really don't know how to do it properly. Man, if anyone's watching this at any point in time and knows the proper way to do this, please let me know. So I don't know why that one basically took away the... There's got to be a setting. So weird. Basically a whole bunch of big waste of time. Editing. Oh god. That probably had something to do with it. Maybe I should just make it square for now. How does it get so messed up?
Oh, I need to revisit that. Alright, for right now, I'm gonna leave it. My SketchUp skills need plenty of work. So the second thing they ask is for the tablet to fit in the top. They want it to be 10 to 12 inches long. Route a groove 4 to 5 inches from the rear of the desktop where you can place a clipboard, whiteboard, tablet, or a book. They didn't say anything about what side it should be on. Half inch wide between a quarter and a half inch deep. So maybe they just want it in the center. Guess I'll put it in the center. It's not gonna hurt. I mean, that would make more sense, I think. The kids get tablets, then, yeah. But if I were gonna have this for myself, I would have like a tablet or a computer set up, and then like another one on the side for like a clipboard or paper or whatever you're copying from, or maybe. It would make sense if they all had the same tablets to do this. The same. Thank you. of this song. Oh. Oh yeah, it's supposed to be angled. Put some kind of angle in there. Let's see. It's not gonna go the right way. Just 70 is probably too much. 80? 80 seems good. Which is only like, what, 10 degrees technically. Depending on where your reference point is. Now I just have to pull this. And take the top. Bam. It's way easier when everything's straight. And those would technically be rounded, so I'll just put that in. Even more difficult, of course.
We're just gonna leave that again. That's another thing I cannot figure out. So try and put. Oh, that's not gonna work, is it? There is like an inverse. Scale on the web version. Scale. Certainly no genius, but I feel pretty good about that one. I should go back and try and find a class or something that shows me how to do that. But it looks like I kind of know what I'm doing from right here. Delete these lines. This is pretty much it. I would like to take the time
and plan out the jig I would use, but to be honest, it's not gonna be super overly complicated. Yeah, I'm gonna send this to the people that are making the desks and ask them if this is actually what they want, because what they drew was a little bit different, but the dimensions they gave were basically this. So I don't want to just start building it if it's not exactly what they need. But I have enough materials to make 10 desks right now. So I think it's 10. I think I have enough for 10 desks. So, and I have a bunch of vacation time off coming up. So yeah, thanks, oil change. This is what's going to be in my garage streaming for the next month or so, I believe, until I finish at least 2 desks. But I'm on the hook for 2 desks, but I bought material for 8 to 10 desks. Yeah, I'll be busy. But hopefully it makes, I don't know. Hopefully it helps some kid. That would be nice. Man, I really got to figure out how to use SketchUp for those corners. Anyway, this space to learn is through the Minnesota Tool Library is the organization I'm doing this for. If you have any questions, you can go to minnesotatoollibrary.org and see if you can help. I'm probably going to end it because I got lots to do. And if anyone wants these plans, if anyone's considering doing something like this, I'd be happy to share them. I got a lot more to draw to. I got a huge Google spreadsheet of all the stuff I want to do. So, lots to draw, lots to build, lots to stream. Anyway, oil change. Thanks for hanging around. I don't know if anyone else is on. Let's go to Twitch. Can raid with my one person. It's just Bonsai Baby, I think. Oh, let's go see Boyd, maybe. Yeah, you have a good one too, man. Thanks for hanging out.